400 years after the arrival of more than 20 enslaved Africans in Jamestown, Virginia, the black body remains the central text in the narrative of a complicated story called America. For all who would understand who we Americans are and how we have arrived, the black body is a central reading. There is no American wealth without reference to black people. Yet the black body is viewed essentially as a problem, sitting at the center of what Gunnar Myrdal characterized in 1944 as an American dilemma. 400 years later, formerly enslaved black bodies and branded black bodies and lynched black bodies and raped black bodies and segregated black bodies are now stopped, frisked, groped, searched, handcuffed, incarcerated, paroled, probated, released, but never emancipated black bodies. There is no clear example of America's unfinished business with the project of racial justice than the 21st century caste system engendered by its prison industrial complex. Moreover, I submit that there is no more significant scandal belying the moral credibility of the American churches than their conspicuous silence as this human catastrophe has unfolded now for more than four decades. Jesus had a record, not surprising given his start. Of course he had a record. Look at the neighborhood he was born in. Born in a barrio called Bethlehem, smuggled as an undocumented immigrant into Egypt, raised in a ghetto called Nazareth. But he came saying, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor, to open the eyes of the blind, to preach liberty to those in captivity. And in his name and in the name of all that is good and justice and righteous and true, we who are people of faith must stand together once again, redeem the soul of America, and say to Pharaoh, let my people go."